Hello guys, welcome back to Bearded Lumber. We're out at the mill today. On the mill behind me, I have a chestnut oak log. It's 17 feet long, roughly about 25 inches on the small end. It's not very good grade. It's got a lot of little twist in it, some shape, but we're cutting some 2x8, 16 foot long deck boards for a trailer. So let's see what we can make out of it. Okay, what happened there is on the very end of the log, I had a knot sticking out and the blade wouldn't run by it. Hard to see down through there, but what I did was just rotate the log a little bit to get the knot up where I just cut it off. Okay. We're getting there. This is the real world. This is what happens when you saw big wood. Turn the lubricator off here. Okay, I've had to roll this log up for where to clear this side. But as I sight down through here, there's a little knot sticking up there that's going to hit. So I'm going to take the chainsaw, take it off so we can at least get one flat cut on this odd shaped log. Sure to clear, but we're close. We're gonna give it a try. See, we got one flat surface finally. You're working with these big logs that are odd shaped. And before you say anything, people, yeah, I know there'll be some waste, but there wasn't a whole lot of good log here to start with. Okay, guys, we've got four flat sides on this log now. I'll be honest, they're not perfectly flat. We were nearing the end of the life of that blade, but I wanted to get as much of this bark off as I could. So we're gonna do two things now. We're gonna change out the Turbo 7 for a resharp one, ready to go. And I'm gonna move the big caterpillar out of the way, and we're gonna start knocking some 2-inch slabs off onto the lift arms for further processing once we get this big log turned down into something we can work with. So hang on. This is easier done with two people, but you can do it by yourself. Now, I don't know if you can see, but we always inspect the drive belt, clean off any residue. The belt on this side is the one that normally gets the dirtiest, especially sawing softwoods where you get a lot of tree sap and stuff. I just give it a quick touch up, get the debris off of it so we get an accurate tension, and then go back and tension the blade. This part of your daily maintenance, if you'll do this, make sure everything goes back together clean, straight. It'll work fine like it's supposed to, until it don't. Okay, I'm gonna get a blade. I'll be right back. What we got here, guys, is a resharp WoodMizer Turbo 7 saw blade, 45,000 thickness. Back on our property. Now, as you've seen in our earlier videos, I'm gonna put the strain gauge on it and check the tension. Tighten the thick side, we'll untension the blade. I'm gonna preload the gauge about a turn and a half. Set it. Reset my dial indicator to zero. That's got way too much tension. We'll back it off. Okay, guys, this is why I use a strain gauge. For some odd reason, I don't know if that blade is a couple thousandths shorter than the ones we normally run, but when I tensioned it, it run up to 25,000 PSI, which is way too much. It's gonna wear out belts, guides, bearings, rollers prematurely. So I backed the tension off and got it back down to 16,000 PSI where we like to run it. And I'm gonna set you over here. We're gonna have to take a few skim cuts, get some of them bad cuts off that I made, and then we'll start whacking out some 2-inch slabs. it's hard to beat a new sharp blade. That's the way a WoodMizer Turbo 7 is going to cut. Now, I don't know if you can see it, but these little lines in here, these are speed defects. I would like to be running just a little bit faster, but this wood is so hard, you got to give the blade just a little break. So I'll sacrifice a few lines. They'll come out in the dry and finish the process. So, there we go. I want to cut down 2 inches, but I can't because it's still a little too wide, so I'm going to have to turn it over. Moved out of the way. We'll set you over here. I'm gonna slide that first cant off on the Okay, folks, that's our two 10 to 10s, 16 foot long. I lost it in there somewhere at the GoPro battery died. We're still new to this, gotta remember to look at them occasionally. But that's some hard cut Western North Carolina. You're not gonna find much worse than dry chestnut oak unless you get into some real dry hickory or pecan. It's hard on blades. You gotta cut it slow. The best you can do is still gonna leave a little bit in the cut. No way to get it out. So to get that all fair, we got these flitches. We're gonna try to make two by eights out of those. And I'm ready to call it a day. Looks like somebody wants to introduce themselves. It's our sawmill dog here. It's a black lab, probably about 7-8 months old. Grandkids, this is their dog. It's currently, it's 8 o'clock at night, so they're probably in the house getting ready for bed. So he's out here hanging out with Papa. Anything to hold us up. Okay, I ain't ever getting no supper, Papa. I know I'm gonna get you supper if I don't hurry and get done, so let's finish this up. Wonder why we charge extra for these big pieces. There's a lot of work in them. Sorry about that, cameras. Move you over here. That shelf's not very friendly. Okay, guys. That took absolutely longer than I wanted, but here we are. We're done. I wanted to get 10 2x8s. We ended up only getting 8, but I got those two 10x10s out of that log, which is great. I don't have to waste another log for that. I got one out here. I'll probably just take a couple slabs off of it, and then what's left, just set it back out on the pile till I need it for something else. But that's gonna do it. I appreciate you tuning in to our channel, Bearded Lumber. Matthew's, it's late in the day. We worked on our kiln all day. He's off spending time with his wife, but he'll be back tomorrow, and we'll have more sawing to do. Thank you for watching. If you would, like, subscribe, and share. Have a wonderful day. See you back at the mill.